dust you, I don't really dust that much, but looking good.
Oh, thank you. I look beautiful.
Hey, how's it been? How long has it been?
Wow, November, December.
It's been about a year and a half.
A year and a half?
Wow!
And you're just vacuuming or just, is there like a lot of vacuuming in my future or is there more going on or is that just?
Well, I mean, all day, I mean, okay, you can't put like an Instagram filter on your chores, you know, like life is more than just like traveling around. So yeah, it's a lot of vacuuming. Oh, hey, we started a YouTube channel though.
We started a YouTube channel?
Oh,
are we famous?
Well, I wouldn't say like famous, but no, we're not famous yet.
No? Hmm. Would have thought we would have been doing better than that, but it's okay, I'm sure you're doing your best. Well, hey, quick question. Just wanted to check before it comes back. I'm making the right decision, right? I mean, I know this was quick, just like 8 months, but it feels right, right?
Tell one, right? Okay, just making sure. Well, I mean, he doesn't like put his socks away all the time and, well, he's not great at doing laundry, but other than that, yeah, I mean, he's pretty good. You really can do much better than him.
Phew. Okay, good. I mean, I thought so. I just wanted to double check. Hey, crazy idea. What if we grab some drinks and we just like reminisce?
Well, I mean, I just have to finish.
You know what?
Yes, I would love to. I would love to.
Yeah? Okay, great. I'll be here, okay? Can't go anywhere else.
Okay.
Oh, hey, you missed a spot. Just over there. Down a little bit. Yeah. Okay, good. You got it. Great job. Okay, I'll be here. Bye.
So back in 2018, I was working with Electrolux in Nashville, Tennessee.
I was living my big city dreams in Chicago, working at the one and only American Girl store.
Life seemed pretty settled. That's when mom popped up. She's like, Beta, you're 28 now. It's kind of time to get married. Let's find you an Indian girl. Should we have your brother find you one? And I was like, Mom, I'll do my best. I'll try and find one myself. If I fail, you guys can go ahead.
I was noticeably single when I remembered the wise advice of my brother-in-law. Carolyn, you should download the Coffee Meets Bagel app. What did I have to lose?
I had my shadi.com as well as Coffee Meets Bagel app, which my friend Mahesh told me about. A few days later, my boss popped up saying, Telvin, you need to go to Chicago. We got some supplier business to take care of. Well, in my mind, that was an interesting opportunity to take care of some personal business. At the sound of Chicago, a light bulb went off. Guess what Chicago has more of? Indian girls. More than Tennessee, at least. So it was time to switch my Coffee Meets Bagel app to Chicago. Bam! Requirements: Catholic, Indian. I guess that's pretty much it.
Requirements: Catholic, anyone. Ooh, he's cute. A sailboat? Yes.
Now, this is not exactly what I had in mind, neither did my mom. But guess what? Catholic, check. That's one criteria. And cute, check. So, worth a shot, isn't it?
I was at the gym on my elliptical and almost fell off when we matched. Now, I know this is a YouTube channel and you think I'm exaggerating, but I'm not. I literally was standing on the elliptical and slipped off when I saw he had swiped right on me too. I didn't know what to say back.
Now, date ideas. How about we go salsa dancing?
Oh,
yes.
Salsa dancing? Okay.
We talked all night.
But in the end, we decided that if we're going to start off a relationship in long distance, we're never really going to show our true selves, so it's probably not going to work.
That was pretty mature, and I agreed.
But we're going to go salsa dancing tomorrow night, right?
Sure.
Why not? Oh, I am going to be wearing the same dress because I got it on sale.
Works for me. After two fun dates in Chicago, it was time to head home back to Nashville. A couple of days later, Catelyn called.
Bring, bring!
Hello?
Hello, George! George, I just don't know what I'm gonna do without you!
That's not my name.
Oh, just like for this skit, I felt like George is a more like timely piece, like nobody really cares. Okay. George, what am I gonna do without you? I'm gonna drive myself just silly, I tell you, just plain silly until I get to see you again! George? That is not how I remember it. I seem to remember Telwyn calling me first.
Tring tring.
Hello?
Catelyn, I'm crazy for you. I don't care what the world says. Let's get married. I already have the date set up.
Oh, who is this? Oh!
Jude Bolria, she's lying.
Well, whoever called first. Things were going really well over the phone for a few weeks, but we weren't sure what our next steps would be. And ultimately, they were Telwyn's wise words that propelled us forward. He said, "Isn't standing still the same as taking a step back?" Okay, I have some friends in Nashville. I'll come for a visit.
And there she was. Catelyn showed up at my doorstep in Nashville. The first thing she kind of said was she invited me to a cruise a year and a half down the line. That's when I thought, wow, this girl is sort of weird. But she seemed fun and innocent, so I thought, let's put on a tour guide hat and show her around town and let's have a fun weekend.
You can say I'm weird all you want, but the booking date was fast approaching and I didn't want to leave him home when I was having fun on an Alaskan cruise. Which turns out by the time it came along, we were married and we had a blast. You can check out our Alaska cruise video right here. But while we're on the subject of fast-paced Carolyn, I also asked him to be my boyfriend on that weekend and he said no.
Actually, what I said was, give me 2 weeks. I was taken by surprise by Catelyn's words, so I needed some time.
So I went back to Chicago, a little brokenhearted, but I knew he'd come around.
Within a week, I realized there was no point in delaying these. So I hopped in my car, got my fake flowers, and headed straight to Chicago. It was an 8-hour drive, and it was snowing like crazy. Now what does snow have to do with the story? It just says how much pain I went through to make this happen.
My friend Carissa and I were in my apartment actually baking homemade Easter goodies for Telwyn and his roommate Abhijit. We were baking Rice Krispie treats and cookies. We were icing little chickies on pretzels. I pulled out all the Pinterest stuffs to mail a nice heartwarming care package to this boy who semi-rejected me, when I get a phone call. But I'm a nice friend, and while I'm sitting with my friend who's tirelessly piping little eyeballs on these cute little ducks, I wasn't gonna answer a phone call from a boy, so I sent it to voicemail.
Actually, I was just prepared to sleep in the car, because I called her, she didn't answer, I could knock at the door, that ruins the whole look of the surprise. So I was like, guess this is it.
So as I'm sitting there continuing to pipe the icing on the pretzel ducks and lambs, my friend Carissa said, "Carolyn, you can answer that." And I'm like, "No, no, 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 I'm here with you. I'm focused on you." But I should probably check my voicemail because he's never left a voicemail before. So I walk in the other room and I get a voicemail and it says, "Hi, if you could call me back, that would be pretty nice. so I decided to call him back. And he says, "Hey, why don't you come to the front door?" Now listen, I am not going to fall for that trick because I refuse to be the dumb girl who ran to the window and looked outside and then was laughed at because I thought that he was there. Because why would he be there? We live 8 hours away from each other and it's snowing outside. So I did not look. And he said, "Okay, you don't have to look. It would be nice if you did, but you don't have to." So I peeked. And I saw him! I lived on a second floor walk-up in Chicago, and I looked down, and there was a man walking on the sidewalk in front of my Chicago apartment, and I screamed. Carissa came running in. "What's wrong?" I said, "He's here!" So I ran downstairs and opened the door, and I hugged him. Oh, it was so exciting. So he and Carissa met, they hit it off, Carissa went home, and Telwyn said, "Let's go to dinner." So we looked up some places around Logan Square, we found a great pizza place, we headed out, and we had an amazing pizza dinner, and we were catching up. Then he walked me back to his car, and we took a little stroll around the neighborhood, when he pulled out of his trunk some flowers that he had brought with him, and they were intertwined with LED lights. And it was so sweet, and he said that this is his formal proposal, and he would like if I were his girlfriend. Now ladies, Indian proposals are not proposals with a diamond ring. So when I heard the word proposal, I was like, whoa, 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 whoa. I know I asked you to be my boyfriend first, but this is moving a little fast. And then he clarified what an Indian proposal is, which is just a formal boyfriend and girlfriend agreement. So that's how it went. So in just under 2 months, we went from first connection on a dating app, Coffee Meets Bagel, to boyfriend and girlfriend. And I also had a date for my cruise. So I decided it was probably time I tell my parents that I had met a boy. Over the next few months, we had so much fun in the rain and the shine. And to give credit where credit is due, my mom, Lynn, played a huge part in Telwyn and I getting together. She had her psychic mom vibes on, and the moment I told her about him and showed her a picture, she looked at me and said, "Carolyn, you should marry him. Don't be dumb. Marry him." Thanks, Mom.
So now to put my mom at ease and before they renew their subscription to Shaadi.com, I had to let them know that I was already dating someone. And guess what? It was a bit nerve-wracking, but I did let them know that I was dating Carolyn, and thankfully she didn't look like an axe murderer, so they were cool with it. So Carolyn was beginning to feel at a standstill at her job, and this traveling back and forth was taking a toll anyway, so we figured it'd be cool to have Carolyn move to Nashville.
Come on! We're here!
Carolyn was here, but Zoe and I, we hadn't come to terms yet.
Oh, please. Within 3 days, Telwyn was already inviting Zoe over for dinner and forgetting completely about me.
At this point, it had been over a year since I'd seen my parents back in India, so I kind of booked their tickets for the coming November.
Anyway, Telwyn's parents came to visit, we met, it was great, and we got married that first weekend. What a story.
Hey, wait a second. I think we missed some details.
Oh, I guess you're right. There were some behind the scenes details. Basically, it was gonna take at least 2 months to get married, you know, by the time you get your marriage license and your Catholic prep courses and your church date settled. And Telwyn's parents were already coming, and if they were coming this November, practically the next time you were gonna see them wasn't going to be until another year. So were we gonna get married now or wait another 18 months? I'll book the church.
Well, there you go. The marriage date was set, and it seemed more like a business decision, to be honest, rather than a romantic one.
So I was in for an awkward few weeks in that weird limbo time when I had a wedding date set. I was supposed to be looking for wedding dresses. I probably needed to invite some people, yet I didn't technically have a fiancé, and I didn't have a wedding ring. So it was a little weird.
Now, Catelyn had landed a new job. So before she joined, we decided on a trip to New Orleans.
Honey, do you see the front of the boat right there?
Yeah.
I was gonna propose to you.
What?
But then I decided not to.
Seriously? That actually happened.
Guys, I didn't have the ring. I just thought it'd be a fun trivia to share at the time.
Yeah, that was real fun.
Well, it is kind of tricky to surprise someone when the date is already set and we're technically engaged already. Tejas and Prachi, my good friends, were coming up to visit me in Nashville. I thought that was a perfect time. I decided on a cliche flash mob. I called up on Bradley, who is one of my closest friends in Nashville. He's a professional dancer and kind of my landlord too. So he decided on the choreography and stuff. Friends Miguel and Ashley joined in, and my roommate Abhijit, we all pitched in. Learned choreography and days when Carolyn was at work and decided to surprise her.
So Telwyn said that we should take Prachi and Tejas downtown to take really nice night shots of the city from the Nashville Pedestrian Bridge. Of course, why wouldn't we do that? So I put on my clothes, I kind of brush my hair, and I get in the car and we go. As we're walking on the pedestrian bridge, I'm taking nice pictures of Prachi when, out of nowhere, I hear my favorite song, and it was actually our very first song that we danced to when we went salsa dancing for our first date, Havana by Camila Cabello. And I stop. Tell it! Somebody's playing your song!
Congrats, guys.
And the greatest part is, I absolutely did not think I was going to be able to be surprised. How could he surprise? surprise me when I already had a wedding date set, but he did, and he did a good job.
Fading in, fading out, on the edge of paradise. Every inch of your skin is a holy grail of godified.
So there you have it. That's the story of how Telwyn and I met. With a little bit of fate, a little bit of luck, and a lot of trust.
The best part is, we didn't play it cool throughout the entire journey.
I told him right away I liked him.
Yeah, things were easy. I liked you. I liked you too.
We didn't play any games.
Yeah, that's pretty much it. We were like kids. And here we are. A few months later, we are here on this YouTube channel for you guys to subscribe, so please do.
Don't forget to like this video, and for daily tidbits, follow us on Instagram. We'll see you there.
See you guys.
Bye.
Guess what Chicago has a lot of? Indian girls. Doesn't make me sound like desperate.
No.
I like you. I like you too. You wanna go dancing? I wanna go dancing too. Am I rambling? Yes, I am. Do we wanna read it? Yes, we do.